I know people think that I expect that I'm going to be successful. I don't have a crystal ball or a formula for success. I have an idea and a vision, and I pray a lot, and I have a lot of great people around me who help lift me. As you saw tonight, they lift me up, and who can't feel supported with that kind of love? So
you've sold 9 million albums as a solo artist. I mentioned this is your fourth one, so, but what between those three albums and this one, what has changed musically as you've gone through the various processes? I mean, this is almost, listening to your albums sometimes is almost like being on the other side of the psychoanalyst couch and seeing where you are at the time. You're welcome.
Well, they're autobiographical. I think I'm willing to be vulnerable. I think I'm willing to be not perfect. My vocals on this record are not spliced and diced, and everything sounds, I don't know about you all out there, but I think, and I love radio, so I don't want to bite the hand that feeds me, but we're getting real slick. We're getting a little bit too perfect. I think we need more guts, and I think we need raw. So we went in and tried to accommodate all the people out there that wanted to hear what they wanted to hear. I got a lot of letters from women saying, do a song about men. I got a lot of songs that I think a lot of people can relate to, but mainly I just wanted to be real, and whatever came out of my mouth, whatever flew out of there, we tried to keep because of the emotion. It wasn't a perfect vocal, but it had stuff on it, you know? Mm. So this album is probably my most raw.
You mentioned radio, but from the production side too, this is a lot more raw, Wynonna. And what did we learn about you that we didn't know before?
That I'm just really whacked out more than ever. and I don't really mind saying that. I'm just one of those people that Arch just said, amen. Where are you, Arch? I feel a lot of joy and a lot of pain in the same day. I mean, I was with the kids today, and I go from that, you know, changing diapers to being up in the middle of all these lovely people who adore me, and it's just bizarre what I live, and I'm going with it, you know? I'm just going to see what happens. I mean, next week I'm on Rosie, next week I'll be... I got stuff going on, so...
Well, speaking of stuff, there are 12 songs in this album. Most albums have 10. There are 12 cuts, and as we get along, we're going to find out... I want to find out kind of where you were as you were thinking about each of these songs. I mean, why you included them on the album as we get along. I mentioned that the new single is number 20 as of tonight, and then we'll come back and talk about it. But we have a very special version, because as we mentioned, when we started this, Wynonna was just minutes ago out on Lower Broad here in Nashville, outside of the Hard Rock Cafe. And did a bunch of songs for a few thousand people. And let's just get this. Here's a version you have never heard before.
Your love started talking.
Your love.
love started talking.
Your love started talking.
Love started talking.
Shut up and listen, it's a power voice. Ha.
Love starts talking, you got no choice.
Shut up and listen, it's a power voice. Ha.
Good to know somebody's still out there listening. Thank you all very much
for coming to my party.
I love you.
Whoa, Wynonna Live. That was Wynonna Live. As recorded out here on Lower Broad just a little bit ago in downtown Nashville, out in front of the Hard Rock Cafe, and Wynonna is here. Tell me about When Love Starts Talking. I'm sure everybody saw you do that on the CMA Awards show, but why'd you want to do that?
Why did I want to do it?
Yeah, what attracted you to it?
I think we need more celebration. I'm just feeling like we need to have joy and, you know, shake it more and get out there. And I don't know, I think, I mean, I can be heavy and dramatic.
Go read Maya song. We'll introduce her in a minute.
But I think I need to, I think it's time to just really appreciate that, yes, love has changed my life, you know. I was on a bus, cruising down life's highways, and all of a sudden, you know, I had this life-changing experience called having children and tapping into what real love is. So maybe I'm full of it right now because I have two babies that teach me every day.
And Grace was just here a second ago.
Yeah, and she reminds me of what really matters. And I have my family surrounding me, and so we're full. We put the fun in dysfunctional, as Mother says.
Should mention too a little connection here from the past. We talked about earlier about Brent Mayer kind of connecting in, but what are you doing? Look at me when you're talking.
Oh, I'm sorry. You know, I've known Lon. Lon was one of my first interviews ever in the world, and he's like a relative. You were there back in 1983.
Mm-hmm.
Back when I was quiet and shy.
Back when you were quiet and shy. But you know, talk about connections to the past. This song, When Love Starts Talking, thank you, was written by, co-written by Jamie O'Hara, who had for the judge.
Who wrote Grandpa.
Yeah. What connection there. We are just really getting started here with Wynonna. We're in the Hard Rock Cafe in Nashville. We've got 11 more songs from the new album to go, and coming up, a very special guest. That's as we continue our world premiere of The Other Side, the brand new album from Wynonna. We'll be right back with more of the world premiere of Wynonna's CD, The Other Side, here at the Hard Rock Cafe, live from Nashville. Live from Nashville, Tennessee, in the Hard Rock Cafe, this is the world premiere of Wynonna's brand new album, The Other Side. It is going to be in stores tomorrow. It's on Curb Universal Records. It's her first album. Now, does that after all these millions sold, do you still get a little nervous? I mean, is this a little bit like giving birth to another baby?
Well, you never get over the feeling of knowing that somebody is listening to what means like your whole deal. I mean, when I go in the studio, I know everybody out there who's a part of the record knows when you do something you love so much, it's like you want people to love your kids, you know? You want people to think they're special, and that's how I feel about my records. And I got a kind of a mediocre review today, kind of a bad review, and I actually found myself feeling...
I'd like to point out that the guy who gave the mediocre review was such a putz.
He didn't even get the name of her most recent release right. He called it Revolution, not Revelations. This guy is not an authority on my sister's
editorial
music. Oh, and
this is live radio, Ashley. This is live, man.
An editorial comment from Ashley Judd. Welcome.
And if he hasn't seen
can kiss the girls you should and walk in fear, I can kickbox.
This runs in the family, doesn't it?
Oh my gosh, I'm so glad I invited her.
The record right. Who is he to be able to write about her?
Well, Ashley is my sister, and she sticks up for me. God bless her. But I think what I feel is I want people to dig me. You never get over that feeling. I get criticized a lot. I make a lot of mistakes, but I make a lot of right choices, too. And today's a good day. So I think every day's different. And knowing that the album's out tomorrow, knowing that people are going to stand there and go, oh, well, you know, what do you think? What do you think, I should buy it or should I buy this? Is a weird feeling. It's like all of a sudden you become a product. And do people want it or not want it? They're, you know, because it's not on sale, you know, it's not on the sale bin yet. So it's a very vulnerable feeling.
One of the important things that you have to remember is what an incredible time you had making the album and the intimacy of being in the studio and surrounded by those people. When you go to bed at night or in the morning, if you're kind of a rock and roll mama like she is, your relationship with your creator and how you feel about having sung that day, that's what counts. And it will touch people.
Yeah, I saw her on the day of her premiere. I know the story.
That's right.
About Jed, women are strong. We land on our 2 feet. We remind women out there what you can be when you do step into, you know, that attitude. When I get off the stage, I become just like everybody else, trying to get a gig and work. And so I'm vulnerable tomorrow because you guys make it or break it. Let's face it. That's the bottom line. Yes, I have my gift. Nobody can take that from me.
It's a lot easier to be confident after your movie's been number one for 2 weeks in a row.
Yes, that is true. And I know that, you know what else too, believe this or not, we are living examples of we've beat the odds so far. Life is about seasons. 1 minute you're up, the next minute you're down. So far, all three Judd women are thriving because of you all. If it wasn't for you, I would have a real job. I know that. So you never get over that feeling of you guys are the reason I'm where I am on this gold lame couch right now at the Hard Rock Cafe, you know. It's the truth.
We already introduced Ashley once, but I think since this
she needs no introduction, this
is the middle of Judd Awareness Month, as proclaimed by Naomi, so I think that, you know.
By the way, she has extended it well into November. For those of you who felt that October was just too short, relax.
And it's really appropriate she's here at this time, too, because the next song I want to play from the new album has a line in it. The first line is about, you know, contains the phrase about your sister, and the song, it's called Come Some Rainy Day. You know, this song is like a song that I'm not sure I would have thought would have been a Wynonna song. It almost sounds like a Bette Midler or a Barbra Streisand type song.
Fine company. I think the hardest part of my job is being willing to stand there and tell people how I feel. That's the hardest thing for people in the 90s. We want to drive the perfect car, have the perfect job, but we want to get down to that raw emotion. That's hard. When I go in the studio, I'm singing deep within my gut. The two men that wrote this song, Bat McGrath, has been waiting 15 years to get a Wynonna cut. 15 years, you guys. He's been waiting for this moment. And that's what it's about. I know that out there, where are you, Bat? Are you here? He's here, so yeah. Probably partying too hard. But that's what Wynonna is about. And tonight, this is for Bat and Billy, who wrote
Billy
Is It Over Yet? And without them, I'd be singing I'm a Little Teapot.
And here it is, the song, one of the 12 new songs to find out on Wynonna's brand new album that we are premiering here for you. The album is called The Other Come Some Rainy Day.
This one's for Ashley.
Live from the Hard Rock Cafe here in Nashville, Tennessee, this is the world premiere of the brand new album from Wynonna. The album is called The Other Side. It's her first for Curb Universal, and it's going to be in stores tomorrow. First big hit single is already number 20 in the nation, When Love Starts Talkin'. And of course, Wynonna is here to talk about all the songs on the album. Ashley Judd is here as well. I asked you before the break, gave you a little time to think now, do you have a favorite song on the album?
Wait a minute. I mean, they're all my favorites. It's so hard.
A four-way tie.
But Come Some Rainy Day, of course, is simply in a class by itself. And then,
because it's all about you.
Because it's all about me.
And Mojo, I must say.
That's a good reason to have
a
favorite.
I love the funk. And don't you throw that mojo on me. And I also, the picture, if you don't buy for the music, by the way, you should buy for the pictures because the album art is so gorgeous. Her pictures are so awesome.
This is where I draw the line.
With this CD. I mean, you have never seen such exquisitely beautiful pictures of her. And the picture that goes with Don't You Throw That Mojo on Me has so much sass and so much attitude. It's gorgeous.
This song is for any woman out there who is tired of staying home and watching her man go out. And I love men, Arch Kelly, wherever you are, honey. I am turning it around tonight. It's about me, honey. And, you know, a woman just has to do what a woman has to do.
Now, but I did not have a chance to see this advanced CD art stuff.
Okay.
So tell me, Ashley, what the picture is that goes with this song.
It's just attitude.
There's a boy named Davis Factor with whom I worked for a magazine, and I thought that he was incredible, so I called Pop because I didn't know how to really approach her. I didn't know if she'd be interested in working with someone who's a complete unknown. He's an unwashed Hollywood type. He wears black fingernail polish. His hair is filthy. But he's a fabulous photographer. And not only did
he really
appreciate
that,
they loved each other and got on so well. She's like his best friend now, and I barely know the guy. And the pictures are tremendous. This one in particular, it's kind of cropped just below the mouth. It's just incredible. You just have to see it. Knock
you
your
have
socks
to go out
off.
And have buy to
go out
it
tomorrow
to
and buy it. And I know, I think, why you like this one. As Ashley says, this one does have some funk to it. So let's get it for
funk.
Everybody. This is Wynonna from the new album. The album is called The Other Side.
And my mama is singing harmony on this song.
Yeah. Don't you throw that mojo on me.
You go where you want.
Wynonna is along to talk about all the songs on the album. And Ashley Judd is with us as well. That was one of her favorites. She's signing autographs and all that stuff.
It's a party.
Let's play another song for everybody right away. Let's talk about Always Will.
My other favorite song tied for fourth place. They're all my favorites,
now, when
but
do,
I love
when
that
do you
one.
Hear these? Ashley, do you hear these like when they're done or along
Each
the way?
Each album has been different. This album was really something that came to me when it was already fully arrived. I didn't want to listen to most of it without her company, but Pop did play this for me in the truck one day, and I so got into the Celtic, Irish, African funk of it. It is so memorable.
Hunter plays the Yulian pipe. Now, I don't know about you, but that's not an instrument you find in country music. But being the rebel that
I am... I'm not sure where you find it, to tell you the truth.
Well,
what is
it's
a Yulian pipe?
It's just like everybody said, oh, if you put horns on no one else on earth, people won't think that's country. And I said, well... But it's Wynonna. So one thing I'm always doing is I follow my heart, which drives people crazy. Sometimes it works, though, in music. And Hunter came in and played Yulian pipe on my song. And let's just say it adds an extra something to it that's really unique. And that's special to me. It's infectious.
What does it sound like?
Listen up.
Besides infectious. Okay, we will. This is another song from Wynonna's new album. This is called Always Will. And listen for those Yulian pipes. Wynonna, complete with Yulian pipes. And Always Will. That's a song you'll find on her brand new album, The Other Side, that we are premiering here for you. This is a great sound. Fantastic sound.
Some things will never change, thank God.
And what is it about what universality of that song wanted you, or made you want to record it?
It's the closest I can get to standing on a mountaintop, feeling God. There's just a point in music. I'll try not to get emotional tonight, but my heart's really full of music right now because it saved my butt. It did. I mean, through all these things I go through, I have my music to step into. And just looking at Harry standing over here in the doorway, feeling like even though we don't really know each other on a daily basis, this song just did something to my soul. I don't know. It's just one of those things. It's like walking into a room and falling in love with somebody. You can't explain it, but it's a feeling that you have. And it's there, and it's heavy, man.
All right. So, I tell you what, we have a phone call. Okay, so let's see what's on their mind. We have Patty, who's listening to 93Q in Houston. Hey, Patty, you're on with Wynonna.
Hi, how are you?
Go, Patty.
I was wondering if Wynonna has a favorite embarrassing moment
that she had from either one of her children.
Well,
Not on your life, honey.
Let's do this instead. Maybe Ashley should tell us what Wynonna
I'm totally rolling the microphone. Embarrassing moment. Isn't that my department? I get to tell those stories on
I'll cut you out of my will.
No, I can't. You know, nobody's ever asked me that. And someday if I write a book, but not today.
Well, Ashley, what's her most
Thanks so much
moment?
For calling, Patty. You know what, Ashley? These babies are so beautifully well-behaved and perfect. They do regular kid stuff and make observations that are occasionally inopportune. But there's really nothing you can say that's embarrassing about Elijah and Grace.
Do you have a favorite Wynonna story that you tell? Any?
Don't
give me that pretty look.
She can still give me a whooping. I thus hold my peace.
All right.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for saying what she did on the back of People magazine about me holding her down and that she had to sock me in the boob to get me off of her.
Thanks, Ashley. I really appreciated that. Third grade action.
Sorry, is that it? That story is now you've learned your lesson. You're not spilling the beans anymore, right?
I actually did that interview in 1993. It was an extra. That's the thing about giving interviews. They're in perpetuity throughout the universe. There's no way you can ever take them back.
Well, I'll tell you what. We are here with Ashley Judd and Wynonna, and we have, when we come back, we've got something very special, another guest star, and we'll take some more of your phone calls if you call us toll-free at 1-800-913-STAR. All that, you know, there is one special guest star. Well, Naomi, of course, was on this last song. But we have another very special guest star on the album, and we'll tell you who it is. We'll play that song next as we continue our world premiere of The Other Side, the brand new album from Wynonna. Live from Nashville, Tennessee, inside the Hard Rock Cafe, I'm Lon Helton along with Wynonna, and we are here because her brand new album hits doors tomorrow. It's on Curb Universal, and it contains, of course, the big hit single, When Love Starts Talkin, that we heard live a little bit earlier when Wynonna was outside singing. We've been joined by Ashley Judd, and also what I consider now the luckiest man on earth, sitting on the same couch with Wynonna and Ashley. John Berry, everybody.
How you doing?
Hey. First, I guess, how's the throat?
It's better.
Because you've been, like, not talking for 30 days.
No.
Talk about humbling.
Yeah. Have you ever had to do that, Wynonna? Can you imagine?
Not yet. No, I can't.
Can you imagine? Well, John is here joining us because one of the songs on the album has John Berry as a duet partner. A really incredible song, especially for anybody that has kids. It really hits you like right between the eyes. It's called We Can't Unmake Love. And John, tell me a little bit about how you got... tell me about getting the call from Wynonna or whoever and how that came about. Or you called her.
Well, we found the song. Billy Walker and I are producing this new album of mine, and I can't remember exactly how the song came to us, but we heard the song and really felt very strongly about it, and I've been wanting to get together with Wynonna and sing a song for so long now.
I was too busy singing with Michael Bolton at the time, and you know, life is really hard, but
now, was your
I've
album,
had to do it.
Was your album done when he came to you with this song?
Yes. I'm one of those people, and I know you all know, the people who really know me know that I can either be your biggest nightmare or your biggest dream come true. There's a very thin line between that. No laughing. And the truth of it is, I was finished. And I'm one of those people, and God bless the dreamer in a sense, because we do dare to dream, but it drives you all nuts because, you know, it doesn't fit into the schedule. And my record was done. And Jerry McDowell was like, no,
from the
you
record
can't,
label.
You can't. Don't do this to me kind of thing. And I said, I feel this way. And Pop, my manager, said, you just have to at least hear it. And John had called, and I thought, you know what? You all saw Grace sitting here. This song happened to me. So I had to do it. It was like one of those callings that I couldn't say no to.
So, John, tell me about making the phone call to her.
Well, we finally got in touch, and I got a copy of it to her, and she felt strongly about it. And we didn't actually get to see each other until it was done. She had finished her part. I had laid down a rough vocal, and she'd come in and done such a beautiful job. Of course, actually, I'd finished my vocal, but then hers was so great, I called mine the rough and went back in and redid mine.
Well, I'm surprised then she didn't go back. I mean, there's, as everybody knows, I mean, the two of you have probably two of the strongest voices in music, period, not just country music. Oh, absolutely. And so I wondered if it got to be a, you know, one would sing their butt off, the next one would do it even more, and just went back and forth.
You know what I love about this song, and I know you all know this, there gets to a point in music where you think, I mean, how loud can they get, you know, and how high can they sing? This is a simple song.
It is.
If you all are looking for, like, the big Star Search ending where, you know, his head explodes and I sing above him, it's not going to happen because this is
a
normal
sweet song
about normal life. And everybody in this life will go through this kind of thing, and we're just singing it. We're not trying to outdo each other. What a concept for men and women to sing together.
Not trying to put on a show, just trying to sing a great song from the heart.
What a concept.
And here it is. You'll find this song on Wynonna's new album, The Other Side, along with John Berry. We Can't Unmake Love. Wow. What a wonderful song.
You Can't Unmake Love.
What a wonderful song.
Sweet message.
And John, we were talking about the fact that this is going to be on your album as well.
Coming out sometime next year.
And when are you going to be able to get back in the studio, do you know?
I don't know.
And actually, we should probably tell everybody that, I mean, the album has been delayed a little bit because you had a little throat problem. They told you to not...
I want everybody to pray for John. Days. Prayer works. I want everyone to lift John up. Because he needs to be singing.
Yeah, I did a little overdoing. Did too many dates this summer, too many airplanes, too many recording sessions, and just stressed out my vocal cords a little bit, and... We've been going to go see some wonderful doctors at the Vanderbilt Voice Clinic, and they've been very helpful, and things are very encouraging. Had an appointment there today, and just got to just rest.
It's almost like I wonder, how much does a person have to go through to get it? I mean, John's already been through one miracle, and I think, I don't know. I don't know why it's happening, but I told him earlier that I think it's happening for a reason.
Yeah.
But when
the
song is meant to be, it will be, and... it will be on his album, my album, and I hope it's a single. You know, it's one of those things that I feel you have to have.
And songwriters are here as well. Will
yes,
Robinson
and
Andy.
Yes,
Andy
they
Sane.
Are. Yes. And I hope they make a lot of money. Because the songwriters, without them, I mean, I know, I hope they're all here tonight. I haven't been able to talk to everybody, but it's a really special time for me because I'm doing something that most people are afraid to do, and that is to do songs, you know, from the underdog, the person who doesn't have a gig and doesn't have a deal. And I believe in giving those people a chance. And so hopefully they'll win like a Song of the Year or something really cool.
Well, that's just great that you brought that song to an army. You sound great together.
Well, I was just thrilled when, you know, we heard that Wag called everybody at the
tell
her,
them what you thought
label.
I'd do. Come on, tell them what you thought I'd do. What?
I don't know what you did. Nobody know what you did. But when we found, because, you know, we were going to put it on our album, and then next thing we know, she's halted production on her record, and she's putting it on hers, too. Thrilled me to death. I just couldn't believe, and we're very excited. Very
That's excited. Fantastic. And thank you for joining us, Mr. Berry.
Yay, John Berry.
Now, when we come back, we've got more of the new music from Wynonna's new album, including, as I mentioned before, she had a hand in writing a song on this album. We'll get to that one next as we continue our world premiere of The Other Side, the brand new album from Wynonna. We are live from the Hard Rock Cafe here in Nashville. I'm Lon Helton, along with Wynonna. The occasion is the world premiere of her brand new album. It's called The Other Side. It's going to be in your stores tomorrow.
Ah.
It contains that big hit single, When Love Starts Talkin. It's on Curb Universal, her very first album for that label. And also, we've been joined by Ashley Judd and John Berry, and we're in the midst of planning something else here, but I'm not sure what's going to happen with that.
I don't
that.
Either. Let's
we'll,
just go
we'll
with
see.
It, Lon.
800-913-STAR is another of the is the phone number, the toll-free number. You can talk to Wynonna. That's 1-800-913-STAR. Another song on The Other Side is the only one you had a hand in writing. So did you get lazy or what?
I was feeling kind of desperate one day. I mean, you've heard it before. You feel something, you write it down. I think, and I want somebody, before we're done tonight, if anyone's got anything they want to share, no. Raise your hand, and if you feel led, let the Lord use you.
I just am tired of being, and I don't want to sound bitter, I want to sound better. I've had my moment of being, you know, the tabloid queen. People don't really know the joy that I do feel, and it's time for me to share that. So what I said one day was, you know what? Troubled heart and a troubled mind, man, is all I'm going to leave behind. I'm moving on down the line. Don't shout me down. I'm doing fine. So I am doing fine. I think I'm a survivor of this stinking business. And I show it in my music. Even though I'm vulnerable to it, I have that attitude, which I think is about 90% of it, don't you think? I mean, how long have you been in the business?
3 years.
I'm young. You know, what keeps you doing what you do? I want to know. I'm asking you a question.
Just
the money? Is it the money?
That, of course.
The chicks?
That must be it on this side. When you sit in the little chair over here, it's nothing like the big Golden May couch. No, you know, the excitement, the love of the music, the people are the best.
I've been rich. I've been poor. Fame and fortune, you know, it was to be taken for granted because Mom and I were so above the clouds. And then one day I found myself at home with no gig, and I know now that I've had my 15 minutes, I'm going to push it to 20. Thank you very much.
Well, as I mentioned, we'll talk about this a little more on the other side. I want you to hear the words to this song. Again, it's one you'll find on the brand new album from Wynonna called The Other Side. Songs she had a hand in writing, Troubled Heart and a Troubled Mind. Wynonna. Yeah. And along with, she wrote that song along with Jamie O'Hara, who we mentioned earlier was a writer of Grandpa in the good old days, and your producer, Brent Mayer.
Where is Brent Mayer, by the way?
Is Brent here?
Where is Brent? We'll have
reunited,
to get him up here.
For everybody who may not know, Brent did all the original Judd's music. And then you guys parted ways for a little bit, but now he's back. So tell me about getting back together on this and kind of, you were apart for a few years. You're both a little older. Hopefully at least one of you matured.
Well, let's just say this. You have to leave home to come back home. I left home. I think there was a moment when I said, I have to go out there and find out who I am. And I think it's really cool that Brent, and the reason why I asked for Brent was because I want him to maybe tell you in his words, I knew coincidence is God's way of keeping invisible. When I went to work with Brent on the Kenny Rogers, Mary Did You Know song, it was in the Judd studio where we did all the Judd records, and Brent was sitting at the console, and I said, this is happening for a reason. And we went to lunch and talked about it, because I didn't have a clue what was going to happen. I thought, I'm either going to go heavy metal, you know, and blow everybody's mind, or, you know, I'm going to go back to the mountaintop and do Appalachian hymns. I don't know. So next thing I know, I'm in the studio with Brent, and I just follow my heart, and it worked.
What did you guys talk about when you were just planning the album? You wanted to do,
no.
But what?
We talked about Brent. Life.
But, I mean, what you wanted to do with this album?
I knew what I didn't want to do. I knew that I didn't want to end up one day being so overproduced that I couldn't find my voice. I knew that I needed to get back to simplicity. I mean, we have faxes and FedExes and everything's technical, and I think we need to get back to the human connection. And so I wanted that for myself. I wanted to get simple and know that I could sit on a stool and sing with a guitar without having all the mirrors and the stuff. I needed that for my own artistry. It's like, remember when you all saw Melissa Etheridge get out there with just her guitar? Not a lot of women are willing to do that, because not a lot of entertainers are willing to do that, because we think we need all that, you know, cool stuff that makes you all think we're magical beings or something. So I wanted to go home and find out what I was made of, and Brent helped me do that.
Any songs in this album that you think are especially close to Judd's music?
It's going to remind you of the past, but it's about the future. Yes, there are things on, and I know every critic, if you're out there listening, you're going to compare me to the Judds. I mean, hello, Mom and I have been together 33 years. You know, we're tight. But I think it's like going out on a date. You don't want the guy to just think you're one thing, you know, and label you and categorize you. We have a lot of facets to our personality. You know me. I don't want to be just one thing. You cannot contain me. And a lot of labels, thank God for Curb Universal, because they are allowing me to be me. And I need that right now, maybe, because I don't know where I belong.
Speaking of that, whatever. They allowed you to be you 12 times. We mentioned once before, there are 12 songs in this album. We got a couple of quick phone calls here. Michelle is in Atlanta listening to Y106 tonight. And Michelle, you are talking with Wynonna.
Hey, Wynonna.
Hey, Michelle.
I have a quick comment and a question. First of all, I'd like to say that we all just love your new single and can't wait to go out tomorrow and buy that new album. And my question is, who were your childhood heroes or who influenced you the most when you were growing up?
Who influenced me the most? Well, I think you all know. I mean, you've read the book, you've seen the movie. She wasn't out of my sight. who influenced me the most were the two strongest women in my life, Ashley and Mom. I don't know what else to tell you because we were so poor that all we had was each other, literally.
Right.
You know, we didn't have extras and crowds that love us. We had each other. There were moments when Mom would be sitting there and we would be, the three of us, thinking, this is a cruel trick. You know, we're on welfare. She's working two jobs, raising two very high-spirited women. And we didn't know what was going to happen. And by the grace of God, we moved out of that. So those were the two people most influential and the ones I couldn't get rid of. It was like we were
right.
always together.
Right.
So.
All right. Well, thanks, Michelle.
Thank you very much.
You love them, you hate them, you can't live without them.
We're on all across Canada tonight, too. So we have Wendy from British Columbia on the line.
Wow.
Hi.
Hey, Wendy.
How are you?
I'm feeling kind of sassy. I got all these people looking at me, so say something good.
I just actually wanted to thank you for your music and your spirit because they mean a lot to me and they've made a really big positive difference in my life. And although we've never met, I feel like there's a connection that you have with your fans that can't really be explained by words. And I was just wondering if you feel that when you're on stage, that connection between you and the fans.
It's scary. It's like inviting someone over to your house. You get everything prepared and right, and they come in the door. And sometimes it's a scary thing because I do leave that door open to my fans, and sometimes they abuse it. Sometimes they are blessed by it, and sometimes they are cursed by it. Sometimes I think it's like at CMA. I'll give you an example of how it works for me. I mean, I got a lot of criticism for CMA because all the guys in the bands were like wearing leather pants, but Wynonna wears leather pants. Oh, my God, she's too edgy. You never know what I'm going to do, right? But I got so much flack for CMA, but I thought to myself, at least I'm willing to get out there and do it and try it, you know, in front of everybody. So I think you see yourself in me. I think there's a part of all of us that just wants to get up on a rooftop and holler. I mean, that's the way I felt tonight. I felt like, man, I just want to get out there and throw down. So, I mean,
and you did.
He knows this feeling.
And you did. We should mention, I think we talked earlier about how Wynonna did a free show out here on Broadway in Nashville for everybody.
Thank
before
you, Wendy.
Came here. This was, you know, this was like a, this was almost like a movie premiere out here. What's your lower lip out for now?
What?
Are you pouting or something?
Well, talk to Ashley. She makes me and what I do look like a real job, seriously. I wouldn't, if people ask me, do I want to act? I mean, I'm the vocalist. Ashley's the drama queen. And Mom's the writer. So all three women, we have our... There is no... And I want to put a stop to this. There's no jealousy. There's healthy competition, which is healthy if it's... I mean, she's got her own thing. I think if she was a musician, it would be different, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But she's got... Hello? Her movie's number one in the box office. And, I mean, somebody walked up to me literally in the last year and said, aren't you Ashley Judd's sister? I mean, what does that tell you, you know? So... Go figure.
Well, I'll tell you what, we've got a lot more to go with Wynonna, and what we're going to do is take a break, come back, play some more music from the new album.
Bye, Wendy.
As we continue our world premiere of The Other Side, the brand new album from Wynonna.